गोल स्कोरिंग एबिलिटी। इन हिज फर्स्ट सीजन एट लियो, विक्टर ओसिमहेन हैज डन एन एग्जेम्पलरी जॉब लीडिंग द लाइन इन लीग वन। हिज मूवमेंट हैज बीन हिज स्टैंड आउट क्वालिटी विद ओसिमहेन रैंकिंग वेरी हाई फॉर एक्सपेक्टेड आउटपुट। नेवर्थलेस, हिज करंट फिनिशिंग इज नॉट एट अ लेवल रिक्वायर्ड ऑफ अ टॉप क्लब जस्ट येट, मीनिंग ही इज करंटली अंडर परफॉर्मिंग हिज एक्सपेक्टेड आउटपुट। अंडर नॉर्मल सर्कमस्टांसेस, ओसिमहेन वुड बी एक्सपेक्टेड टू हैव अराउंड 15 गोल्स इन लीग वन। However, he has only 13 due to subpar finishing. It must be kept in mind that players improve their finishing as they age, so this is not a major concern. Like Werner, Osimhen has also a wide range of finishing in his locker, but predominantly focuses on his strong foot. For a player of his aerial ability, it is slightly surprising that he does not have a headed league goal this season. But if he keeps getting into good positions and executing his leaps well, the headed goals will inevitably come. The main concern for any buying club at this point would be his lack of consistent goal scoring pedigree. With this season being Osimhen's first big season in a top 5 league, clubs may understandably be wary of spending big on a player whose sample size is limited to only one season. But this should not take anything away from his achievements this season. If Osimhen can replicate this season's performances, and there is plenty of evidence to suggest he can, then he is on course to be a top class centre forward. He gets a rating of 7.5 out of 10 for his goal scoring ability. Tactical suitability. Osimhen, like Abraham, is a player who prefers having few touches and most of them in the box. In fact, he contributes lesser than Abraham to his team's general play. However, this could also be influenced by Leo's rather direct style, with the coach instructing Osimhen to strictly stay in the box and focus on what he does best, that is, score. Osimhen is also a fantastic presser and harries opponents non-stop over the course of a match, where he does require significant work in his combination play with his teammates, with Osimhen prone to erratic touches and passes. The Nigerian has a good eye for spotting tricky passes in the final third, but is often let down by his execution. This issue is aggravated when he is under pressure from opponents, but given the fact that he is just 22, he has huge room for improvement in this field provided he puts his mind towards it. Despite his rapid speed, Osimhen rarely moves with the ball and his ball carrying and dribbling numbers are surprisingly limited. Instead, his focus lies in taking big touches beyond defenders or moving off the ball and putting himself in situations where he is ready to attack the ball in the box. Inside the box, he is extremely active and ready to pounce on any loose touches by opponents. While Osimhen would require a fair deal of coaching in order to improve his combination play, his pressing and ability to move in the box makes him a good fit as a potential Abraham alternative. Once Osimhen is put in a direct foot race with an opponent, it is not often that he loses. This type of scenario could be executed on a more consistent basis in a team with good long-range passers such as Ziyech, Jorginho and Mateo Kovacic. We give him a rating of 7.5 in this aspect. Economic feasibility. Leo are believed to have placed a 60 million euro price tag on Osimhen this summer, even after the COVID-19 market slump. Being a relatively lower profile player when compared to other targets, it can be assumed for the sake of this study that Osimhen's basic wage demands will lie in the region of 100k euros a week. Using these numbers, his annual FFP cost comes to about 17.5 million euros. While lower than others in the study, it is still a fairly significant outlay for a player who has just had a breakout year and is still raw in many aspects of the game. We give him a rating of 7.5 out of 10 for his economic feasibility. That makes a total of 22 out of 30 or 73.33% for Victor Osimhen.